Hey guys, Mark here, welcome to the channel. In this video we're going to be testing some mods we've done to this. Now I did a little bit of tinkering around before. I had it lowered where it sat down to here and I didn't like it because the body kept kind of wanting to roll on the servo, so I didn't like that, so I've put it back to where it was, so it's lowered as much as I can get it at the moment. But these tires were on the Capra and I didn't like how hard they were. They just didn't seem to perform very well at all. Well, that was my gut feeling. So what I did was I've pulled them apart and I've taken out the additional weighted collars that were in there. And what I think was happening was that they were pushing the foams out and making the external part of the tire too hard. So we've modified that. We've got a new battery lead in here, so now we can put in a little shorty instead of having the big 2S brick. So now we've done all these mods, let's go and test them. All right, we're gonna follow the comp line as best as we can, so let's go. I absolutely love this truck. Oh, that's crazy, look at that. I just don't get this one out often enough, but I do actually really enjoy driving this one. So I'm hoping that these tyres perform better on this truck than what they did with the Capra. I feel like in the Capra, and that would have been my fault, well, not my fault, but I feel like they were too hard and the foams with too much with the weight cores in them. They seem to be performing really, really well here at the moment so far. Look at that. This rig definitely could do with a steering servo upgrade. So far, at the very least, the beadlocks making a big difference for it. Caught up on something there. And we've also got a much lighter battery in it. We used to have the big brick in the top of it, the big 2S-er. Now we've got a tiny little shorty in it. This is going to be a bit of a challenge. This will be a good test. Not call a shit handy like a boss. The same difficult lines that we did with the TRX6. that another go. Well, don't speak too soon, Mark. Oh, yeah, we got there. Or we're going to. Yeah. Well done, Nightcrawler. Could combine this thing with Capra axles and get it better weighted. This thing is the bomb. You'd have like kind of the ultimate crawler. There you go. Did you see that, guys? That there proves that not only is a stock servo in this rubbish, but that 35 kilo servo upgrade in the TRX6 really is that good, because that wouldn't even turn then. So this is going to get a steering servo upgrade. these tyres are working so much better on this car, and they are working so much better without those weighted cores making the foams expand out too much. I think we might go and try the bonus lines on this. Right, so we're going 30. Okay, we're up section one. Section two. I said there's only two cars so far that have passed this test, the Ecto and the TRX6 now. This is going to be a difficult challenge. Get it over that edge, yes. Oh. Yes, and the Nightcrawler pulls it off as well. Righto, one more to go to match the TRX6. Righto. This one I'm nervous about. There's no dispute that the TRX6 has just got that length about it to keep pushing. So these are, in case you're wondering, Jetco Conquerors Ultra Soft Compound. No way. We actually did it. And easier than the TRX6. Alright guys, I think that pretty much concludes this video. I'd say that was a huge success, going to the small, much smaller battery with the weight in the top and changing these tyres over from the Capra to this. They've performed way better on this, and the addition of the bead locks and a bit of weight down low for it, and obviously unsprung weight. Yeah, this has been a huge success. So now, back to the Capra, of which tyres we're going to leave on there, whether we get another set or whether the rowdies work out. So, peace out. Thank you for always tuning in, guys. I'll see you in the next video.